Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use pages to create a scrolling carousel. Let's get started. Here, you see we have three different images for the carousel scroll. Place each image alongside each other. You can do this either by moving the images manually or by typing in the X position based on the screen width. For example, since my screen width is 750, the X position of image 2 needs to be set to 750, and the X position of image 3 needs to be set to 750 times 2, or 1500. Then, group all three of these images together into a folder called Carousel. Change the horizontal view of this Carousel folder from Static to Page. Now you'll be able to see the second image in your viewer, but you won't be able to pull it all the way into view. To change that, drag the folder's blue border in so that it only covers the screen width. Now you'll be able to swipe back and forth. Let's add some carousel dots to set expectations for our users. Add a rectangle by tapping R. Make its fill color white and change its radius so that it has a circular shape. Duplicate the layer twice so that you have three circles. Set the opacity of the two new circles to 50%. Make sure that the three circles are aligned evenly, and then group them into a folder. Now that they're grouped together, make sure they're centered on the screen. Let's also reorder and rename them to make this next part easier for us. Open the drivers section above. By default, you'll see the Scroll X property of the carousel selected, which is exactly what we want. Select all three dot layers and tap the plus button. Select the opacity property. This will automatically add a keyframe of the current dot opacity settings at keyframe 0. Drag the marker along the driver timeline to the next screen and add another keyframe here by clicking the plus button. You'll notice that the keyframe is the exact same position as the X position we set for the screen earlier. Set the opacity of the second dot to 100% and the opacity of the first dot to 50%. Since we've set another keyframe here, any changes we make to the dot opacity settings will be automatically saved. Now you can see that the opacity of these two dots changes as you scroll between these two screens. Let's do the same thing for the last screen. Drag the marker to the next screen, which in my case is the 1500 mark. Add keyframes here as well, and change the opacities accordingly. That's it.